Griselda!
Gwendolyn. It's so quiet now. The sound of battle seems so far away. It seems I cannot follow my king into the final battle.
No, don't give up.
Gwendolyn, please take this. I have no use for it now. This spear has slain many foes, making a mountain of corpses. The king, father, will undoubtedly praise my actions.
I'm sure he will.
Do I see tears in your eyes? You're too kind, sister. Please, do not cry. Your older sister will leave the world as a great warrior. Tis so dark here. Gwendolyn, I can't see you.
Griselda, I won't let you be alone for long. I shall be by your side soon enough.
We have lost this battle. There are simply too many enemies. So that is the Shadow Knight. Rumor has it he has made a deal with Halya to acquire such strength. What power?
I will face him.
Princess?
You must not!
Kill me now. How long do you intend to keep me pinned down?
Go on. Run away. This battle is over. Any more deaths will just be a waste.
Oh, I'm glad to see you're safe. I had feared you were...
At this point, I cannot go back.
Please, wait. But what good are troops that have lost their leader?
Gwendolyn, you've returned.
I have an announcement, Your Majesty, regarding the invasion. Our troops have been lost. The foes had more reinforcements than we had anticipated. We were forced to enter a battle of attrition. The Valkyries suffered many casualties, including Griselda, our commander.
I know of Griselda's fate.
Griselda fought bravely for you to the very end. She entrusted me with a spear in her final moments.
She was the most gallant and noble of all my warriors. That spear is a special weapon known as a cipher. It collects spirits that haunt battlefields and uses their power to smite enemies. Henceforth, you shall wield the spear as you please. We shall launch another assault on the enemy. I shall personally take part in this battle. Send the troops when you're prepared.
Father! Is that all you have to say about Griselda?
Words will not bring your sister back. Tis no time for sentimentality.
We're moving out now. Inform the troops. Griselda.
So you're going to battle in order to win your father's love.
That's not true. I'm fighting for my kingdom and my own pride. I may fall in battle, but that is a fate all our countrymen face.
Don't try to hide the truth from me. You seek death so that you may earn the love you so desperately seek.
Quiet!
I am but a phantom. I represent your innermost thoughts. I am pathetic. I've never been loved since the day I was born. Giving your life for your father will not make your death worthwhile. You will simply die, like Griselda died.
Stop it! If I sacrifice myself for my duty, Father will surely show his love for me. Surely.
I have a report, Your Highness. The Aesir have launched an all-out assault. They are attacking our headquarters with all their soldiers. The paladins fight valiantly, but 'tis only a matter of time till they are overrun.
Odin, I see he risks his own life with this strategy of his.
Here are your orders. Quickly, call back the troops from the front line and attack them from behind. Use everything we have. Attack from both sides and annihilate them!
Our king is bestowed with divine grace. Prepare yourself, Queen of the Ghosts. I, King Odin's daughter Gwendolyn, shall be the one to take your life.
So, you call me a ghost? The Demon Lord's daughter is bold indeed. It seems that my reinforcements have arrived. It's about time, sorcerer.
Your Majesty, my sincerest apologies for my tardiness. Come, Belial, my faithful dragon.
Let us put this to the test. Do you still dare to speak so impudently before my mighty dragon? King Odin, Please rejoice. The enemies are retreating.
It seems that it is finally over. Have Brigand's troops hunt down any remaining enemy forces. Go, inform all our soldiers of our victory. Sound the horn and allow them to celebrate our glory. Now, leave me.
King Odin.
Yes, there it is. The crystallization cauldron. The fairies have kept it hidden for so long. Oh, do you see this mysterious light? Now it is finally mine. This power will grant me victory in any battle. What's happening?
Oh no! What happened to the glow? The cauldron's light has gone out.
Do you know where my father... where I may find the king?
The king is with the crystallization cauldron.
What? Who goes there? What are you doing here?
These stupid battles all over again. Cauldron is a source of disaster. I will not allow the crystallization cauldron to be used any further. Not by you, nor by the Queen of the Fairies.
Wait!
Do you understand how much we have sacrificed here? If it all was for some hunk of scrap iron, it is a disgrace to the dead. I'll catch that witch and make her spill her guts about that cauldron. If she plays dumb, her head will fly. Someone, stop that fool before he leaves. No, he cannot be serious about opposing me. I shall find the witch. Gwendolyn, I leave the rest to you.
Father, please wait. A king cannot idly abandon his own castle. If I had not let the witch go, this would not have happened. Allow me to redeem myself. I shall capture the witch.
Gwendolyn, wait.
Yes, Father?
Heed my words. Do not cause undue harm to the witch. She is special. Be respectful.
As you wish, Your Majesty. Let you escape this time.
You'll never get your wish, Valkyrie. Confront me all you want, but you cannot change my resolve. Go back and inform the Demon Lord. I will not listen to your pleas.
You have no choice in the matter. If you insist that you will not repair the cauldron...
That evil spear and my chain are both ciphers. If we battle, it will be a serious affair.
You're hesitating. Bluffing will only get you so far. If you value your life, obey the king.
You ignorant fool. You cut short your own life by meddling in my affairs. Using the crystallization cauldron will doom the entire world. That accursed cauldron served as a trigger to the horror that befell my native country of Valentine. It is Cataclysm's womb. and it should not exist.
The great magical country of Valentine is said to have been destroyed overnight. I am aware of the story that you describe. The Valentine prophecies say the world will be destroyed by 5 disasters. One of those 5 involves a furnace that spews despair. You say that line refers to the crystallization cauldron. 'Tis but a rumor from a ruined land.
War will spread across the world. The winning country will rule over the entire land. Your country's ambition is merely a convenient lie for the Demon Lord.
Do you imply that my king is deceiving everyone? I will not hear this mockery! Stop this nonsense! I shall take your life if I must!
Wait! Both of you! Cease fighting!
Father! Why are you here?
I had a premonition of something like this, so I came here.
Odin.
I cannot allow you to hurt one another. Gwendolyn, step away. Do not interrupt what I have to say. Velvet. You look so much like your mother. My dear daughter, why are you acting against me?
Do not call me your daughter. Do you think I am a fool? While the nations of Valentine and Ragnanaval were at war, you disguised yourself and seduced my mother, the princess, with sweet words. And you were quick to flee when she became pregnant. Because my mother gave birth to an enemy's child, she was executed for loving you. It is the same as if you had killed her yourself.
That is not true, my child. We did not know each other's real names, nor our ranks. I did not run away from her. We were torn apart. I truly loved the princess.
Father.
Lies! If you loved my mother, who is this other daughter here? I do not think of you as my father, and I have no desire to help you.
Well, well. I followed the king and stumbled into a royal spat. Fraternizing with the enemy. Who could have guessed?
Brigand.
Although their demise was sudden, Valentine was still our enemy. And while the battle raged, the king had an affair with their princess and even had a child. Deary me, the subjects will be most upset. But as I am a loyal servant of my king, I will carry this secret to my grave. But that cauldron is another story. Now come, winsome little witch. You will help us gain its might.
How did you stop the magic furnace? There must be some type of key to it. Speak, witch, if you value your life.
Even if I told you, there is nothing you could do. The cauldron may only be controlled by a ring named Tetrell. A terrible dragon holds the ring presently. Wagner, feared by all, keeps the ring within his stomach.
How could this be?
Wagner, of all things. My lord! What do you plan for the girl who has harmed our country so? If we cannot use the cauldron's magic, the inevitable final battle shall be a recreation of the awful war against Valentine. How are we to inform the soldiers and the citizens?
I know.
We must sacrifice her flesh to the dragon and retrieve the ring. Command me to sacrifice the witch. Suppress everyone's anger with blood! I sense my king is not content. Is there any reason to protect this witch? Is there anything at all between our king and his daughter from an enemy land?
Brigand, you...
Ah, sire, I hear your command. The witch shall be sacrificed. Away with her!
Father? That girl, Velvet, is she someone special to you, Father?
She resembles the princess I once loved. To lose her again, now. Gwendolyn, please leave me. I do not wish you to see me like this.
My mother and sister devoted their lives to the king. I never heard him devote so many words of affection to me, ever.
If you leave her, she will be executed. That will make you the king's only surviving daughter. You will no longer have to compete for his love.
True. If only she were gone. But if she dies, Father will suffer even more.
Are you saying you will save her? This girl who cares nothing for you? If you do, you are committing treason. You will no longer be welcome here. Will you persist in this folly? There will be no way to redeem yourself. How can you willingly choose to walk the path to your own death?
We haven't found the dragon yet. Is Wagner really here, as this girl says he is? Go find him! All of you, go! I don't mind that he isn't here. I never wanted to meet the dragon anyway. Even if you are sacrificed, there's no guarantee it will give me the ring. I'd be needlessly putting my life in jeopardy.
What are you planning to do?
This is what I will tell your father. The dragon killed you here, as I commanded.
You? Why are you doing this?
Hurry! Run away! If you still wish to live, go!
Gwendolyn, you've done a very foolish thing.
This isn't about using the cauldron, is it? Why do you seek her death so fervently?
Do you really want to know? After she is dead, I will inform the nation that the witch was the king's daughter. And after having a child with the enemy, he was such a monster that he killed her. The people will wonder if such a man is fit to be king.
I never thought one of my king's trusted generals could be so treacherous.
After I deal with you, I'll recapture that girl and offer her to the dragon. Why don't you try begging for mercy? Perhaps you could be the new king's mistress. Hmm?
Disobeyed me and killed my chief vassal. The fact that you are my daughter cannot save you from punishment. The citizens of the nation will never stand for it.
You're trembling. Do you regret your actions?
There is no excuse for what I did. I am prepared to face the consequences. I shall endure any form of punishment.
Rebellious Valkyrie, you will undergo the customary punishment. A sleeping spell will be cast upon you. When you awaken, your heart will belong to a stranger. Your pride and honor will be stripped away. You will devote your life to him, bear his children, and grow old.
I care not. My actions spared you from suffering.
Oh, my dear, what have I done?
You are most certainly my precious daughter.
I have longed to hear you say those words. Oh, Father. So that's it. I am no longer a Valkyrie. It's as if it was all a dream.
There you are, Gwendolyn.
Oswald, the Shadow Knight. So I have been forced to accept the enemy's elite soldier as my husband. It seems I am destined to suffer.
I must take my leave soon. But before I go, I would like to give you something. Your hand, please.
This ring.
I'm sorry. I have nothing else worthy of being presented to you. This is a beautiful ring that I obtained from a dragon named Vogner.
The ring to Trell?
Will you accept it?
Why are you giving me something so precious?
How can I say it? Well, it's because I want to see you smile, to see you happy.
I am a warrior. My only happiness stems from battle.
You sound unsure. Do you fancy him?
No. That man is my enemy. When I think about all the warriors he has slain, I cannot forgive him. No matter how kind he is to me. My father's spell is making me feel this way. 'Tis not love. It simply cannot be. I shall seek vengeance the moment it presents itself. That is what my father would want me to do.
There is no reason for you to remain loyal to a king who has abandoned you.
I just want to do what will make my father happy.
That is what Oswald just said to you. He yearns for your love, in the same way you yearn for your father's.
It matters not. For now, I am simply a prisoner being manipulated by my captor.
Oswald! Are you leaving so soon?
Yes. I have an oath to keep. Gwendolyn, will you wait for me?
I belong to you now. If you command me to wait, I shall obey.
You are not an object, and I will not allow anyone to treat you thus. Never. I take my leave. I shall be back soon.
This ring is undoubtedly to Trell. This will allow the cauldron to be activated. I must take it to my father.
princess!
I come with a message for the king.
Ah! What are you doing?
I may have been banished, but I will not tolerate such treatment.
The king has ordered us to kill you on sight.
Not quite. Don't you recognize me?
You're Lord Brigand!
The Queen of the Underworld thinks highly of me. I have been delegated to discipline King Odin, who steals jewels from her realm. Observe, the pitiful king is merely a puppet to my will. This country is finally mine!
So you're behind the chaos in this land. You disgust me. Leave the king at once!
I'll tear off those wings of yours and remove my shame for having known you. Your soul shall become my plaything.
Father, you've returned.
Gwendolyn, you made it back safely.
I have violated your edict, but I have important information for you. Please take this. This ring is to Trell.
Good work, Gwendolyn. That man, I was right to tempt Oswald.
Tempt? What do you mean, Father?
He and I formed a pact. I would give you to him if he could slay the dragon Wagner. Obviously, he succeeded. The ring is a prize from that battle. With your latest actions, you have atoned for your past transgressions. Welcome back, my child. Your honor has been restored.
The Shadow Knight, Oswald. He fought the dragon. For me. No. This is no longer where I belong.
Gwendolyn.
Farewell. I wish you in the heavens well. Please tell me, where is he gone?
He went to the Fire Kingdom to fulfill a promise he made to the king there. He's been gone for some time now. Something may have happened.
To fulfill a promise? What is happening in the Fire Kingdom? My heart aches with each passing day. I cannot bear it. I cannot wait like this.
The Great King Onyx is just ahead.
Welcome, Princess of Ragnarvel.
It has been a while, Your Majesty.
You are as beautiful as ever. 'Tis always a pleasure to welcome you to our kingdom. This way, please. Allow us to entertain you.
Your Majesty, I have come here seeking answers. I have heard that my husband Oswald has come to this land. Are you aware of this?
As much as I would like to say that I am not, I cannot lie in the face of such beauty. He is certainly here. He is fighting for me.
Fighting?
Yes, against a dragon that is terrorizing our country. Some say that this dragon is Leventhan, the one mentioned in the prophecies concerning the world's end. Our fire and our swords have had no effect on this newborn dragon. I thought his Beldarrhoeve may have some effect. But since I have heard no news, I assume it was useless as well.
Why Oswald?
You may not know this, but King Odin had already promised your hand to me. It would have helped unify both our countries. But your father went back on his word, and instead gave you to that tortured soul. In compensation for letting the issue drop quietly, Oswald made me a promise. He vowed to fight for his life on my behalf whenever I asked.
Oswald did this for me?
He may die. He may even already be dead. I can void our agreement and save him if you will be my bride. It's up to you, Gwendolyn. As long as you become mine.
Inferno King, you are no different than the men back home. I am not an object.
What? Get her, Vulcans! Capture her, but don't harm her.
Dragon like this. This doesn't look good.
Oswald!
Huh? Why are you here? I can't make it. I can't go on.
Are grave. They must be attended to immediately.
See what his pride has cost him? Leave him be. You have been banished for disgracing your country, but you are still astonishing. To be able to defeat the dragon from the prophecies, you intrigue me even more.
Oswald has fought for you, and the dragon has been defeated. We are returning to the castle.
Why? Why him? That man has been selected by the Queen of the Dead. He will eventually die as her servant. His very existence is torment. Leave that doomed soul and take my hand.
Your Majesty, if you persist in insulting my husband, my spear will take your hand. If you do not want your life extinguished, get out of my sight!
How intense. Just like a flame. I shall pay my respects to such intensity and back down for now. The promise has been kept. Let us leave it at that. But remember, you are the one that stokes the embers of my heart.
Has Oswald's condition changed?
He is resting at the moment.
I see.
May I ask you something?
What is it?
I have heard rumors suggesting that Oswald has some type of connection to the Queen of Death.
Well,
In order to increase my Beldereaver's power, my father sold me to her.
Oswald! You need to rest!
And just as he wished, I acquired the cursed power of the Shadow Knight. But in compensation for this contract, the Hallia lurk about everywhere. They are waiting for the moment my power fades.
How terrible!
As long as I have the Beldereaver, The Hall you fear me and stay away. But this power continues to be my curse. That was a close call back there. I must thank you. But Gwendolyn, why did you go to the Fire Kingdom? What did you discuss with Onyx?
I apologize for not obeying your command to stay here. But I was so worried and concerned about you. I could not sit idly by.
Huh? You were worried about me?
Your Highness!
You belong to my father's troops.
I have something to report. Ragnarnival suffered a crushing defeat from the Vanir under their new queen. They have seized the area around the cauldron.
That can't be! How is the king? Is the king all right?
King Odin has been wounded by arcane bolts and has returned to the castle. But his injuries are severe, and he is in no shape to do battle. The enemy will surely take this opportunity to invade the castle. The precious ring he received from your highness has been taken away.
You gave away the ring I presented to you? No. Oh. This was all a part of the Demon Lord's scheme. So, I was used as a puppet.
Wait a moment. I really...
Your Highness, for now, please return to the kingdom and assist King Odin.
I cannot return to my father, but I will serve my responsibility as the king's daughter and fight. Please inform the king of my intentions.
You're going to attack alone? You're asking to be killed!
If I can retrieve that ring, the entire war will change.
Are you doing this for your father? Or for him?
I never imagined losing someone could be so terrifying. I don't want to lose him.
For a Valkyrie to come alone to a place like this?
'Tis Odin's witch. Let us hear what she has to say.
Your Majesty, please allow me to introduce myself. My name is Gwendolyn. I am King Odin's daughter. I have been exiled from my country, but circumstances forced me to come here. I have but one request. The ring to Trell. It was given to me as a gift. It is extremely precious to me. I humbly request that you give me the ring.
You barged in here to ask that? What cheek! Do you really expect us to hand the ring that controls the cauldron over to you?
We cannot give you the ring. This ring is a spoil of war taken from the Demon Lord. I am its rightful owner now. If you do not leave, I shall be forced to demonstrate my Reblum's power.
Yeah!
Oswald, where have you gone? I told him to get some rest.
Oh, Brahm. I see him.
Ah, so there he is.
Unrequited love is quite painful. But 'tis even more painful to be imprisoned by someone for whom you feel nothing. Gwendolyn, I had the slightest glimmer of hope in my heart, and now it is gone.
What is that? It's a messenger of death. Oswald!
What's wrong, Oswald? Your sword is so close, if you do not reach for it, my scythe shall claim you. You have no hope, nor power. You are a shell of a man, filled with despair. Now come. You belong to my queen for all eternity.
Oswald. Oh, Gwendolyn. 'Tis a relief to find you safe.
Where is Oswald?
Gwendolyn, please listen to me. This is the truth. The Halya has gone to the Netherworld. A place the living cannot go. 'Tis impossible for you to rescue him.
No. I know of one person who is able to make this possible.
Who?
The Demon Lord, Odin.
Looking slightly thinner. I've been waiting for you, Gwendolyn. I have heard of your exploits. Assaulting the enemy with just one spear. Retrieving the ring from those cunning and shrewd lasses. As long as we have the power to control the cauldron, their plans will go awry. You are the most wonderful daughter in the cosmos. You are as precious as that ring. Now, present your king with the treasures of victory.
This ring represents a bond with someone special. I cannot let it go. The reason I have come today is to inquire about how to enter the Netherworld.
What foolishness is this? Give me the ring.
You should know, Father, since you travel there to collect crystals. Will you please hear my request? Please, Father!
A daughter that has been banished wishes to make a deal with her father, the king of the nation? Ah, very well. In exchange for the ring, I shall escort you to the Netherworld's border.
Father...
Now, hand me the ring.
No, not until I make it back from the Netherworld.
How irritating. Barging in here without an invitation. You're as arrogant as your father. You, daughter of the petty thief who steals my jewels. Don't delude yourself into thinking that you'll leave here alive.
Great Queen of the Dead, please let Oswald go. Please return my husband.
Well, well. come running after your master like a lapdog.
Oswald!
His life has been given to me in exchange for power. He walks along the abyss of eternal death while serving alongside me. He was pledged to be mine before he ever met you. You are a nuisance to us. Allow me to personally extinguish your life.
The Valkyrie do not fear death, and if death cannot be avoided, then I welcome my fate. But losing Oswald to you is more painful than death itself.
So you say. You have no idea. What do you plan to do with that sphere made from my jewels? Look around you. Many souls merge together to become crystals, then return to the world above. You're risking your very soul by playing with that sphere. And now the time has come to receive your punishment.
Ha!
both the living and the dead could exist in this land. Because I bridge the gap between these two worlds. Now those that are still alive will forever be barred from entering. The path will close and all ties to your world will be severed. Death will become more horrifying and abominable than ever before. When the world sees its demise, remember the fury you unleashed.
Oswald!
Gwendolyn, hold on! The Netherworld has been sealed. The only way to enter that land now is to accept death. There is no other way.
Oswald! You're awake.
The only thing that can overcome death is pure love. I can no longer collect crystals from the Netherworld. But if I can regain the ring and the cauldron, I have no need for them. Fulfill your promise. Give me the ring.
This is a symbol of Oswald's love. Right now, it represents all I am. If you take this away, there will be nothing left of me. If you must take it, my life must be taken too.
Gwendolyn.
Stop this nonsense! What you believe to be everything is merely an illusion. You are married because I ordered it.
Love is an illusion to begin with. I do not fear losing honor, but I am terrified of losing this illusion.
You fool! Are you saying you will sacrifice your life and your pride just for love?
Stop it! Do you really want to do this to your own child?
This is unforgivable. You are ruining my plans. But my dear, beloved daughter... Look at your father. I am powerless against your decisions. If I am to be any kind of father, I must show you compassion. Do as you wish.
Father!
Silence! Speak no more, disloyal one. Holder of the Beldarrivir, I entrust my daughter to you.
Gwendolyn, it pains me to keep you with me, knowing that you have such conflicting feelings. But even though I knew that, I could not stop myself from pursuing you.
Oswald, I do not mind if my emotions have been caused by a spell. If I can be by your side, I will endure any hardship.
You are a shining star that lit my way as I roamed the darkened earth. Until I met you, my heart was empty. But now it is different. I have experienced both happiness and fear. Happiness in experiencing the light that is your love, and fear of losing it. A light that is more precious than life itself.
It will never disappear. My love will shine like the stars forever. Please, don't let me go.